KBDFans Tofu family brings a simple, unfussy aesthetic with quality anodizing at a reasonable price point. I have the HHKB version that mimics the iconic look of PFU's HHKB for the Cherry MX crowd. This isn't a comprehensive build guide, but I thought I'd highlight some of the main points that might cause problems. This kit comes with a hot swappable PCB, so it's great if you don't want to bother soldering or you want to test some switches, in principle at least. Hotswap keyboard kits like the KBDFans HHKB Tofu are pretty much easy mode, but there are still things that aren't as clear as they ought to be. You should have tested the PCB and have your stabilizers installed first. It's possible that the number of screws you get may differ slightly from what I got. You should have at least 8 small screws and then at least 5 longer ones. I got 2 slightly different types of longer screws. Position the PCB over the standoffs in the top of the case. You remembered the stabilizers, right? Use the smaller screws to attach the PCB. The terrible magnetic properties of the screws make this step harder than it should be. Take 2 of the little magnets and put them into the weight in the same orientation. You can make sure you're doing it right by putting them near each other and noting which ends are which. You need to carefully place the weight into the slot without the magnets coming out. If you've done it right, the slider will stay in place whichever side it's on. All that's left is to put your switches in. I found it easier to do this out of the case so I could see that the legs were going in correctly. Inspect each switch and make sure the legs are as straight as they can be. If they're not, you risk bending them and causing them to not work. Try to insert the switch straight into the plate and PCB rather than at an angle. I managed to insert every switch without bending any pins. Test your PCB again in switch hitter and you're up and running. The layout that was flashed on my PCB was just a standard 60% with nothing really useful on the function layer. It's pretty much useless for most people who want to use F1 to F12 or adjust their backlight or just use control. You can set up your own layout using the QMKKeyboard.cn. Select the KBDFan 6X from the list. Now you can assign the keys to do what you want. Say you want control where caps currently is. Just click on caps and then either press control on the keyboard you're using or click on KC caps and select L control. Annoyingly, that box will close and you'll need to reopen it each time. Click the up arrow to select a different layer to modify. Here you can put your F row and arrows. Those are both under the secondary tab. You can also set a key to put your keyboard into bootloader mode so you can flash it. Don't forget that one. Once you've finished with the layout, go to Setting, name your keyboard and layout and save your configuration. You can use this file to make it easy to alter your layout in future. Then go to Compile and download your .hex. QMKToolbox is an easy way to flash your layout, but if you're a Windows user, you'll need to install some drivers first. Download and extract the contents of the zip in the Driver Installer folder. Double-click the installalldrivers.bat file and wait patiently while it installs every driver you or your grandchildren will ever need. Now you can download and run QMKToolbox. Either press the button on the PCB or hold space and B while plugging in the USB cable. QMKToolbox should show a message that it has detected your keyboard. Browse for your .hex file and select ATmega32U4 from the drop-down. Now click. When you see that it's done and your keyboard has been disconnected, it'll be ready to use. Hope that helps some people out there with what should be a fairly straightforward build and setup. I'll see you next time.